Hi, this is Monica from Ruby Soup with Spelled Juice, and today I am bringing you a very quick video where I am showing some books that I bought at Junibacken. Junibacken is an amusement park dedicated to Astrid Lingren. Astrid Lingren was a Swedish author of such books as Pippi Longstocking and Ronja the Robber's Daughter, and my personal relationship to her is a little bit complicated, but I think my favorite book by hers is Ronja the Robber's Daughter. I think that's a really empowering book that sends a lot of really interesting messages about standing up to authority, even when it's your loved ones. So you should definitely check out that book if you haven't read it yet. But basically, this amusement park has like a little train where they take you through all the books that she has written, and they also have Pippi Longstocking's house. And one thing that they had this year, I don't know if they're gonna have it next year, but they had made installations of a lot of other children's authors here in Sweden. They had installations by Pija Lindenbaum, who is a fantastic children's author. You should definitely check out her picture books. She has very unconventional little girls in her stories, and she's also had one book where the main character's uncle is clearly gay and has a male life partner. And she also has written about boys that want to play with Barbie dolls and just really fantastic stories. And they had a little thing where there was a wolf and the back was painted with Gittan, one of her characters, who's playing with the wolves, and that was taken from one of her first books. They also had a little dragon that a princess was riding on, that was from a book by Jan Lööf, and they had a little shop from another children's book that I hadn't really read, but it was very cute, and I had actually read a lot of the books when I was a very small child, so it was very nostalgic for me. And then they have a gift shop. It was kind of cool because they had like a lot of picture books in Swedish and a lot of chapter books in Swedish. But they also had foreign languages, and Finnish was one of the languages that they had there. They also had Estonian, and they had German, and they had French, of course. And it was actually a very vast variation of European languages. And I do actually speak Swedish, so I ended up but just buying from the Swedish section. And they had a very interesting collection of picture books, and the picture books were quite cheap compared to how they often cost in bookstores. So I purchased 3, and I'll show them to you. Now, this one is called Sussa and Nettie, and it is written by a Japanese author called Roi Arai. And Roi Arai has won the Astrid Lindgren Memorial Award. I've talked about that award on this channel before too, but basically it's like getting the Nobel Prize for writing children's and young adult literature. And this gentleman here, he writes picture books. I have read one of his other picture books, which was When is the Bus Arriving? And I thought that was okay. It was very cute, but it was very much like you're supposed to read this to toddlers. And it's basically just about a man who's waiting for a bus and all these things are showing up and the bus never shows up. So then he just walks to the place where he's supposed to go. It wasn't a story that goes beyond its reading audience. It's similar to Where the Wild Things Are, that it's a exploration of a child's mind and their imagination. And let's see if I can maybe show a little bit what it looks like inside. If I can find a good... Here we go. This is kind of what it looks like inside. This guy actually won the award in 2005, I'm reading here on the back cover. I also bought a picture book penned by a Korean author called Home Alone, and the author is called Ho Baek Lee. I think this is based on her own memories when she was sometimes left home alone as a child. And she lives in a place where her parents go off to work And her grandmother hasn't quite shown up yet to take care of her, so basically this little bunny here on the cover has to deal with being at home alone for a few hours by herself. And it sounds like a super cute story, and I actually really like children's books that tell very serious big emotions with very cute images. I think it contrasts very well in picture books. This is what it looks like. And then the last thing I got was a picture book by a Chinese author, and this is actually translated by Chin Lit. That is like a publishing house run by Anna Chen Gustafsson, who has also translated Moyan's books and Jan Lianke's books into Swedish. And they have actually now started to not only translate adult literary fiction, but they have started doing picture books as well, and this is very exciting. I'm hoping that they'll also translate in some of the so-called middle grade books that are written in Chinese. That would actually be really cool. But basically, this is a Little Red Riding Hood retelling. But Red Riding Hood is blind in this book. And I think that that's super awesome that there's a picture book that has blind representation. Have to see how they deal with that, of course. But considering the good reviews that this guy... Oh, I should maybe actually, before I show you the pictures, tell you his name. Han Chu. And this is called The Blind Red Riding Hood and... The wolf. And I'll show you what it looks like a little bit inside. Let's see if I find a good picture. Oh, this one's lovely. It's just such nice colors. I don't know, I guess Han Chu has drawn this himself. I assume so. And it was so much... It was actually so much fun to purchase those three picture books because there was amusement park had a lot of small children there, of course, because parents bring their kids. And there was a little boy who he really wanted to buy these two toy cars that his parents had told him he could have. And he was trying to be like an adult, so he didn't see that I was there trying to purchase these books. So he came up to the cashier and he put his cars there and he was waving... Hi, to the cashier, and it was so cute. I was thinking about patting his head, but I thought that maybe the parents would find that offensive, so I opted out of that. So, those were the books that I bought at Junibacken. Have you guys ever been to Junibacken? Are you guys curious about visiting the place? Have you heard of these picture books before? Do you have any favorite picture books? Because I'm actually looking for recommendations, so please feel free to tell me about them. And if you like this video, click the like button, subscribe, and I'll talk to you later.